What's up, guys? I'm Chad, and this is the 2022 Street Glide Special. Coming up, we're gonna do a full review, we're gonna ride it, and we're gonna talk about some of the differences between the Street Glide Special and Street Glide Standard. So stay tuned, unless you don't care about any of that. All right, so first, let's talk about things you get on the Special that you do not get on the Standard. Number one, 114 motor. Prodigy wheels. Daymaker headlight. Stretch saddlebags. Updated center console. The Standard comes with the old style that has the button that you pop up and then you unscrew the cap. This is new, it's sleek, and it's got the offset gas cap. Painted inner fairing, upgraded speakers, and the GTS Standard. It's an option on the Standard, the Street Glide Standard. Last but not least, the finish. Whether you want black or chrome, you have that option on the Special, whereas the Standard, you can only get chrome. And it's not even all chrome, some of it's like brushed aluminum. So now that that's out of the way, let's talk about the Street Glide Special overall. Another great thing in Special models is the bags. So these are stretch bags, and versus the Standard, where it kind of blocks off and goes all the way around and hangs above the exhaust, it kind of slopes down and gives you a little bit different side profile, and then it wraps around the exhaust towards the back. So something else Harley did in 2017 that not a lot of people talk about is the Showa dual bending valve front suspension. So it's not like night and day, but it definitely is noticeable. In my opinion, you'll notice it in low speed maneuverability and like high speed cornering. It doesn't change your highway cruiser, cruise riding, but for low speed maneuverability and cornering, it definitely makes a difference, in my opinion. In 2019, Harley gave us the GTS. So this is a big upgrade over the 6.5 boom audio that they had before. It's faster, it has more processing power, and it has multi-touch, so it feels more like your smartphone, your iPhone, or your Android. It's Gorilla Glass, so it's extremely durable, and it doesn't do that peeling thing that the older ones did if you left them in the sun for too long. You can touch this through a glove, like through a really thick glove. You couldn't do that on the previous generation. The maps boot up immediately, whereas the older generation, you had to wait probably 30 or 40 seconds for that map to boot up. It took forever. That's no exaggeration. It's just a better feel overall. You can pinch to zoom on your maps. My favorite thing about the map settings on this is it has lane departure detection. So if you're on a 6-lane highway and you don't know which exit you're supposed to take because there's 5 different options, it'll tell you which lane to be in for that specific exit. That's one of my favorite options that's actually led me to use the navigation on these things versus just use my phone, because before it was kind of crap. I would just use my phone. They've done a good job on this setup. So the upgraded audio that you get on the Special versus the Standard, it's not like astronomical. It's not going to blow your eardrums out, and it's not something you'll even be able to hear doing like 75, 80 miles an hour. It still needs work. You still probably should go Rockford Fosgate. But it is a noticeable difference in terms of clarity, and it does get a little bit louder than the stock speakers on the Standard. I wish they would put something more loud in this thing so you can actually hear it on the highway, because as of right now, you can't hear it. So another big upgrade is RDRS, which I forgot to mention. That's an option on the Standard, and it's also an option on the Special. Most of the Specials come with it. Most of the Standards don't come with it. So RDRS is it's an electronic assist package. So it has things like drag torque slip control, which prevents your back tire from slipping when you downshift heavily. It has things like traction control, ABS, and all three of those functions. It has a corner assisted function as well. It's got hill start assist. So if you're on a hill, as long as you're in gear, clutch is engaged, squeeze the front brake to engage your hill start assist, and it locks the back wheel. Whenever you let off your clutch and start to throttle out, it disengages the brake, so you don't have to worry about feathering the clutch to come off that hill or working your brake at the same time. It makes things easy for you. Rain mode and tire pressure monitoring system are all functions of the RDRS system. I'm a big fan of that setup. I wouldn't buy a Special without it. Something that I don't mention enough is the fact that these are Brembo brakes. Harley and Brembo partnered up in 2014 to develop these brakes. Well, they probably partnered up before that, but they actually released them in 2014. This bike stops really well for a 830-pound motorcycle. So one of the more controversial subjects in Harley-Davidson is Road Glide or Street Glide. There's guys that swear on everything that the Road Glide rides better on the highway. I'll agree, it may help out a little bit, but it shouldn't be enough to sway you, Road Glide or Street Glide. In my opinion, the way you should choose is, do you think it looks good? And then sit on the bike and find out ergonomically what fits better for you. Because the Street Glide is a little bit closer toward you in terms of the dash setup. The Road Glide's a little bit further away. I personally love the look of the Street Glide. I do think that the Road Glide handles better when you're like getting down in twisties. I will say that. But as far as highway riding, which is always someone's argument when I talk to them about Road Glide versus Street Glide, I don't notice a big enough difference for it to sway my opinion. I always catch heat when I talk about Road Glide versus Street Glide. But again, this is my opinion. Everyone's entitled to a different opinion, and I've heard them all. So that's gonna wrap it up for the review portion. I'm gonna take this thing out for a spin and give you my honest opinion as it's happening. So stay tuned. We're gonna steal some of the company gas before we ride. So got it good, see me just fine. There we go. Turn this baby on, we got this camera going. All right. And we're cruising. I think we've got everything we need. Got the drone, check. Got the camera for cool shots, check. Got that. Pop a little gas in this baby. Try to maneuver through the floor without putting my feet down because there's motorcycles everywhere. Think I'll be good going this way. We got an avenue to go. I haven't done this in a while. Last time I did this, a lot of people commented on it. My low speed maneuverability skills. I ride through here every day when I sell motorcycles, and it's kind of funny to say, but customers like it. Cruising through service, split the gap. Through the service doors, not putting my feet down. There's a Road King in my way, so that's pretty sick. Fuel in, give her some cranks. See if we can bust a U-turn right here without putting the feet down. There's a Road Glide with a sidecar. We took that on trade last week. All right, we can speed it up a little bit. There we go. Nah, I need the back brake. Can't do that. All right. Split the gap. So this is our motorcycle, so I'm not gonna rag this thing out like I do the Harley demos. Kinda keep it chill. Huge upgrade from the standard, in my opinion. Like I said, not just because of like top end power, that's not really noticeable at all, but if you're going to be doing any kind of two-up riding, it's definitely essential on the Limited. The Limited's got so much weight, having that extra torque on the 114 is necessary. It prevents you from having to like downshift into a lower gear to find any kind of power. This motor makes a ton of power from, I'm telling you, like 1800, 2000 RPMs. Roll into it and you're there. Something I like about the Street Glide over the Road Glide is the ergonomics, the way I feel when I sit on it. The Street Glide just feels more comfortable to me, naturally. I also like the way it looks. I get a lot of guys, particularly guys that ride a lot of miles, that prefer the Road Glide, so you know, there may be something there. I've put a decent amount of miles on a Road Glide. I don't notice a huge difference. Not enough for me to make the decision to buy a shark nose fairing versus a bat wing. I do like the fact that on the Road Glide you get a little bit more storage. Street Glide has almost no storage at all. Something they need to work on for sure. Road Glide, you get two pockets. The right one's a little bit bigger than the left one. The Street Glide, you get one little pocket on the right side, and you could probably put a stick of gum, maybe a little thing of Tic Tacs in there. Taller bars. Factory 47 12-inch bars are perfect for me on this bike. They're not obnoxious. They're tall enough to where they get my arms up and kind of relieve my shoulders of any kind of pain. Anything taller than like 14s to me are obnoxious, like 16s. But if you're 6'3", 6'4", I could definitely see the need for it. This for long rides would not be comfortable because having your hands down low like this kind of rounds your shoulders off. The bad thing that comes with bars is kind of turns you into a sail. In terms of heat, I had a twin cam 110 motor on my Lowrider S, and that thing put out some serious heat. And then before that, I had a 2015 Street Bob with a 103 in it. That thing made a lot of heat too. So it's a motorcycle, you're still gonna get some heat from this thing. It's not gonna go away entirely, but the Milwaukee makes a lot less heat than the twin cam did. The Milwaukee 8 runs a lot cooler than the twin cam does. It's definitely noticeable. Like, it's 85 degrees right now, 85 degrees right now, something like that. And I don't have any problems with heat. I just got riding maybe 10 minutes ago, but even then, that's enough time for this thing to come up to full operating temperature and give you issues. But it's not a problem. Twin cam, especially on the 110, the 110 brought a lot of heat. For those of you that are kind of on the border between a Street Glide or a Road Glide, or even a Street Glide Special or a Street Glide Standard, you guys should definitely take them both out for a ride. And in the review portion, I said I was going to talk about Road Glide versus Street Glide. I didn't really get into it. I just talked about my preference and my opinion. As far as the difference is the Street Glide fairing is mounted to the handlebars, and the Road Glide fairing is mounted to the frame. The benefit of that is the fairing takes a brunt of the wind for you, and it doesn't transfer that energy into the bars. It just pushes straight through the frame. Whereas a Street Glide, you'll feel gusts, you'll feel a little bit of pushback from any kind of wind resistance on the handlebars. I mean, I don't, but that's the story, and they're sticking to it. All right, guys, well, that wraps it up. I didn't have a whole lot to talk about. Hope you enjoyed the review. I hope you got something out of it. If I said something that offended you, then just let me know in the comments like you guys usually do. Tell me how stupid I am and how wrong I am. As always, leave a comment if you have a suggestion, if you like something, if you didn't like it. Please subscribe, like the video, it helps out. And click the bell icon if you want to keep up to date with all the videos I drop. I'm being more consistent with my videos lately. I've got a couple more planned. I think you guys will like them. So see you guys next time.